Hi friends, welcome to next session on RHCSA certification training program brought to you by SkillPedia, transforming the talent. My name is Ram. This is session 15, introduction to networking. We are in part 3, as I've been talking about, session 3. There are 6 sessions in this section. Linux shells, we have done. Standard commands, we have done. Managing text files in Linux, we have done. Local online documentation was the previous session. And this is introduction to networking, this session. Session 16 will be networking, network configuration and troubleshooting. Agenda of the session is IPv4 networks, networks and routing, tools and commands, ping command and traceroute command, current network adapters, configuring a network adapter, IP as a diagnostic tool, routing tables with IP route command, dynamically configuring IP address with a dhclient, and display network connection information with SS command. So you'll see in this session, you will understand networking related commands and tools. So TCP/IP is a series of protocols organized in layers known as protocol suite. IP addresses help you communicate across a network. A number of TCP/IP tools and configurations are available to help you manage a network. Although the focus of current network is still IPv4 addressing, some organizations have mandated a move towards IPv6, IP version 6 networks. When we talk about IPv4 networks, we have these 5 classes. Class A, where the IP range starts from 1.1.1.0 to 127.255.255.255. This allows these many hosts. Class B, start with 128.0.0.0 up to 191.255.255.255. That allows you 165,534 hosts. Class C is 192.0.0.0 up to 223.255.255.255, which allows up to 254 computers. And then class D is 224 to 239, reserved for multicast, and 240 to 255, reserved for experimental uses. These are 5 classes. Every computer that communicate on network needs an IP address. Some addresses are assigned permanently to a particular computer. These are known as static addresses. Others are leased or taken on lease from a DHCP server, which stands for Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol server, for a limited amount of time. These are known as dynamic IP addresses. IPv4 addresses are 32-bit binary numbers and are expressed in dot decimal notation, such as 192.168.122.50. So this is basically 8 bits or 1 byte, 8 bits or 1 byte, 8 bits or 1 byte, 8 bits or 1 byte. Totally, this is what we have. Each decimal octet representing 8 bits or 1 byte. An IP address is made up of 2 parts, a network address and the host part. These are categorized into different classes, which was given in the previous slide, which define the size of the network and the host part of the address. There are some private IP addresses which cannot be assigned to any computer. For example, 10.0.0 to 10.255.255.255. So we call it as 10.0.0.0/8. Then 172.168.16.0 up to 168.31.255. So this makes 172.168.16/12. And then 192.168.0.0 to 192.168.255.255, which actually makes RFC 1918. We call it as RFC 1918 reserved IP addresses. These IP addresses, which are specified here with this point which I was talking about. We call them as RFC 198, reserved IP addresses. These are allowed only for local networking or local area network, means within an organization. They cannot be used for public IP address of a website or a computer. That means they are not allowed outside your premises, outside your company. Then address is 127.0.0.0 through 127.255 are used for loopback communication on a local host. Network and routing. To determine the network and the host part, IP addresses are associated with a subnet mask, also known as net mask or simply the prefix. This can be represented in the same dot decimal notation used for IPv4 addresses. For example, 255.255.255.0 is a subnet mask which is made up of 24 binary ones and 8 zeros. An alternative notation is known as CIDR block or CIDR range, classless interdomain routing, or CIDR notation, and consists of slash followed by the number that indicate amount of 1 bits in the network, which means essentially if I want to mask this 8 plus 8 plus 8, which makes 24, so I can represent the same thing as slash 24, right? So if I mask only these two, 255 255, I can use is a slash 16, right? So this way we can use the CIDR notation, that is classless interdomain routing notation, we using slash followed by the number of bits or ones. Given an IP address and a subnet mask, it provides a logical AND between IP address and the subnet mask. For example, if the IP address is 192.168.122.50 with a net mask of 124, then this 24 means first 3 octets are fixed. Only this much can change. So which essentially means these 3 octets represent the network part, where the last byte represents the host identifier, which gives you total 254 or 255 IP addresses or 255 hosts. That is why we call it as host identifier. 3 IP addresses define a network: network address, broadcast address, and subnet mask. The network address is always the first IP address in the range, which end with 0. That is 250, like for example 192.168.122.0. That is the network address. Broadcast address is always the last IP, which is 255. Subnet mask define the network and the host portion of an IP address, which is this much. You can assign IP addresses between the network and broadcast address to any computer on the network. Means you cannot assign ending with 0 to a specific computer. You cannot assign 255 to a specific computer ending with that, right? In between, whatever addresses are there, you can assign any of them. Now, let's define the range of addresses for a private network. Start with private network address 192.168.127. 122.0 and the subnet mask 255.255.255.0. Based on these two addresses, the broadcast address is 255, means 192.168.122.255, and the IP range is available from 1 to 254. These many IP addresses can be given to any computer, any host in the network. That subnet mask is defined by 24. Therefore, the given network can be represented by this 192.168.0/24. IP addresses are assigned to network interfaces, means the NIC, network interface cards. A host with multiple network interfaces that forward traffic across different network is called a router. And a gateway, very simple definition. If you are sitting in your house, from one room to another, you can directly go. You don't need anything else. But to go to another house, you have to get into one particular room of your house where you have the main gate. That main gate, that room is called the gateway. So in computer world also, if we have a network, one computer which is connected to the outside world can be used as the gateway, and the IP address of that computer will be the gateway IP. So gateway is an IP address that defines the junction. As I'm explaining the concept of this home junction between the local network, like if our house is network of rooms, then how to connect to the other houses and other networks. It is a part of local network and is assigned to a router with an IP address on a different network. The gateway IP address is configured in the routing table for the local system defined by IP route command. Tools and commands. The commands used in earlier versions like IP config or if config, ARP and netstat and root have been deprecated. So they are not recommended now. That is if config, ARP, netstat and root. Single comprehensive command is IP. That is basically a tool which gives you all features, all the requirements are fulfilled by the single tool called IP. Supports more advanced features, in fact, than the that could have been handled by these individual commands. RHCL 8, in fact, RHCL 8 names network interfaces based on their physical location, like E number or EMX for onboard network interfaces, and ENP X S Y. This means ENP 0 S 8, ENP 0 S 3. Or this one like PCI slots. You may find the first onboard network interface to be named as ENO1, while an interface on PCI slot bus number 3 slot 0 will be named as ENP3S0. Similarly, PCI bus 0 slot 3 will be ENP0S3. Some commands are given in the table on the next slide, which I will explain. Other important network commands are ping and traceroute, which are often used to diagnose and troubleshoot the network problems. Now the important commands. IP hyphen S optional link shows the link status and the IP address information for all network interfaces. Or you can simply type IP space A or IP space address. Then IP address add and the IP address of your choice, followed by dev keyword and then the interface name. This will assign the IP address and the netmask to ENP0S3 interface on your system. IP NEIGH will show you the ARP table. IP space root will show the routing table. SS space DUPNA will show the all the listing and non-listing socket on all listening and non-listening sockets along with the program to which they belong, right? So we are going to try each one of them. So the ping command, first of all, let's try with ping and some of these commands. Okay, first is ss-tunpa, and you will see what package, which software is using which IP address. So this is used by DNS mask, PID, process ID and this, right? So you will see all the commands which port is used by which command, like SSHD is using port number 22. 5353 is being used by Avahi daemon. Similarly, 111 is used by this. So this way you see what port is used by which package. Similarly, you want to try ping command, ping the SkillPedia, ping space SkillPedia.co will give you the IP address where the SkillPedia is hosted, the IP address of the server on which the SkillPedia is running. Then we can specify, use the traceroute command, traceroute SkillPedia.co will give you the route, to that server. Then IP space route will give you the route table or the routing table. If you look at here, default via 10.0.0.2, which is attached to device ENP0S3. Similarly, this is another one through DHCP. Then there's another IP address, 192.168.122.2, which is going through ENP0S8. So this way, they are the how the routing, how the routing is happening on my system. So IP space A will give me all the IP addresses of my system, or IP space ADDR will give the same thing, or IP ADDR show, and then specific device name ENP0S3 will show me the IP address of a specific device. So that's how you can see the IP addresses: ping command, traceroute command, SS command, IP route command. All right. So we have just done the ping command, and we try ping the IP address, and the host name also we tried. Traceroute command automates the process just described by tracking the route path to the destination. For example, to find the path to IP address 192.168.20.5, you can type traceroute hyphen n followed by the IP address. So that will tell you what all hosts are coming in between, or hops are coming in between, and what is what machines it is reaching through. Hyphen n option tells traceroute to display IP addresses rather than the host name. The command also shows the route trip time, RTT, that is route trip time, to reach each hop along with the path. Some traceroute command options require route privileges. Another command that serves the same purpose is tracepath. It does not require route privileges. As I am working as super user or root, and I am using traceroute command. By default, traceroute relies on UDP, raw packets, with an increasing time to live, TTL, value in the IP header in order to find the route path to a given destination. Sometimes a firewall along the path may block the UDP packets. In that case, you may try to run traceroute with hyphen L or hyphen T option to enable ICMP or TCP packets, like traceroute hyphen I or traceroute hyphen T. The IP command, which I showed some examples, can display the current state of active network adapters. It also can be used to assign network addresses and more. The IP link show display the link status of active network adapter. Hyphen S switch you can use if you want to display the statistics about the network performance. IP address show display the IP address information. So you can use IP address show, and I demonstrated this command. Then also you can use IPAS or IP address show or IP address show. So you can see that abbreviations can be used, short form can be used, full name can also be used. Configure a network adapter. You can also use IP to assign IP address information to a network interface card, as was given in the table. IP address at 192.168.122.150, like this is the IP address which I want to assign to ENP0S3. To make sure the changes worked, you can run this command, IP address show ENP0S3. Let's try this command. So I'm assigning it to a different IP address. So let me show the IP address of ENP0S8 first, which is 192.168.122.50. which can also be verified from this command /etc/sysconfig/network-scripts-ifcfg-enp0s8, which you will see here. So let me change this IP address directly from the command, and I want to assign IP address 192.168.122.150 rather than 50 to this device. So I changed the IP address. Let me verify now. It is not replaced yet on this command, you can see. So I need to shut down this interface and bring it up again. If down, ENP0S8, and then if up ENP0S8, and I have specified the IP address and to this device EN192.168.122/124. Now I can use IP address ADDR show ENP0S8, and you see the IP address is not changed though. This is surprising. Let me verify once again. IP address add 192.168.122.50/24 dev ENP0S8. Let me see. And I can see that, yes, it is assigned. I can see that IP address is assigned by this command. Yes, it is there. Now I can verify with ping command, ping 192.168.122.50. And yes, I'm able to ping that with that IP address, that 150 IP address. One second, 150, yes, I'm able to ping that. So IP address is assigned using this command. That's confirmed now. With the right option, the IP command can modify additional network settings. To make sure changes survive a reboot, you need to make appropriate changes to the configuration file in this directory, which I showed because that was specific setting. So that means if you make changes like this, I repeat, if you change the IP address using this command, that will not survive the reboot. Which essentially means you have to change the make the changes permanently to the file which I demonstrated. Then more on IP commands, like if you use IP link set device, the device name up, this will activate the specific device. IP link set device, device name down, it will shut down. IP address flush device, flush dev device name, remove all IP addresses from the specified interface. IP link set device, device name TXQLAN, that is the transaction queue query length. TXQL length, this will change the length of the transmit queue for the specified interface. IP link set device, device name MTU followed by the number, it will specify maximum transmission unit as specified in bytes, and this N specify how many bytes you want. IP link set device, device option promise on, what does it mean? This activate promiscuous mode. What is this promiscuous mode? This mode allows the network adapter to read all packets received, not just the packets addressed to this particular host. This can be used to analyze the network for problems or to try decipher messages between other hosts. And then we can use IP link set device, device name and off. So this will deactivate that mode. Now this is the command. IP link set device. ENP0S3 down, this will shut down the device ENP0S3. Similarly, you want to set it up, you can use this command up ENP link set device, device name up. However, a couple of more intuitive scripts are designed to control network, which I used in my example, my demonstration, if up and if down. That is much more easier to use, and I prefer that, by the way. So if up ENP0S3. Unlike the IP command, they call appropriate configuration file and script in this directory. For example, if up ENP0S3. I use that ENP0S8 if you notice that. IP as a diagnostic tool. The address resolution protocol ARP associates the hardware address of a network interface with an IP address. IP space NEIGH command display the table of hardware IP addresses on the local computer. This command can help detect problems such as duplicate addresses on the network. If needed, you can command. This command can be used to set or modify ARP tables entries manually. Let us verify. So let's verify IP NEIGH show. So this will show me the IP address of the device and the physical address or the MAC address. Alright, this is the IP command, IP NEIGH. The first column in the output list, the known IP addresses on the LAN. followed by interface to which the neighbor is attached, and its link layer address, that is MAC address, which I showed. Thus, last entry shows whether or not the neighbor's hardware address is reachable. If you notice, I got that address stale. I got that entry stale was given. This may indicate that ARP cache timeout has expired since a packet was last seen from that host. If the ARP table is empty, no recent connections exist to other systems on local network. Routing table with IP route. This is the command I demonstrated right in the beginning. IP route command displays the routing table. When run with -r switch, IP-r route, this command look for etc host file and the DNS servers to display host name rather than numeric IP addresses. Routing table normally include a reference to the default gateway address, for example, IP route. So let's verify IP route command once again. So IP-r root. So you will see the host names are, there is no host name specified in my etc host file. Had it been the case, it would have displayed the host name rather than the IP addresses. So that means whether I use it with -r or without -r, it does not make any change, and it displays the IP addresses only. For this routing table, the gateway IP address 192.168.122, as in my case also. Any network packet with a destination other than 192.168.122.0 network are sent through the gateway address. The system at gateway address, usually a router, forward that packet to the next router according to its routing table until it gets to a router that is directly connected to the destination IP which you are trying to reach. Dynamic configure IP address with a DHC client. If you have a DHCP server in your neighborhood and you want to take the IP address from that server, you can use the dhclient command, dhclient or dhclient, followed by the network adapter or Ethernet card to which you want to assign that IP address which is to be given by the DHCP server. The network options configured through DHCP server include the IP address, network mask, gateway address for access to external network, and the IP address of any DNS server for that network. Means you will get multiple entries or multiple details from the DH client or from the DHCP server through DH client. It also adds the IP address of the DNS server to etcresolve.conf file. The SS command is a very good command. SS command display the network connections like SS-TUNA 4. 4 means the IP version 4. It shows all. All means -A because of this. So it shows all network sockets using 4 IPv4 addresses because of this 4, and both TCP, that is UDP U protocols in numeric -N. If the P switch is specified, SS will also show the PID of the process using each socket. So let's try this SSTUNP, in fact. So TUNP, and I'm using going to use the P also, which will show the process ID also. So the process name and the process ID. So that gives you what all IP addresses, what all ports. So local address, colon port number, peer address, colon port number, right? Net ID, state, received, sent, and the commands or the packages and the process IDs. At the end of the output, you may see peer address, which I saw. Port number is just the source port on the remote server. Corresponding local address specifies the port number of 22 for a connection from this, for example. You may also see the second entry with the same port number which identifies the associated SS daemon listening for connections. And that's all for this session. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.